Hello, my dear inquisitors, the people who want to inquire and understand the reality of things by using critical thinking. Now, today, in the context of Aurat March, we will be discussing different points, especially the 10 points that I have given above. So I hope I am audible and you people are also available. Today we are discussing an important movement, Aurat March, and understanding some of the implications, repercussions from scientific, philosophical point of view, though you will be also touching the religious dimensions. If I'm audible, so please like this audio broadcast and let us continue the discussion. Basically, this is a gender studies discussion because gender studies is an interdisciplinary academic field devoted to analyzing gender identity and gender representation. So we have two important dimensions. One is gender identity and the other is gendered representation. Please like my important terminologies so that you are involved in this discussion. Later on, I will be taking your questions. So first I said that this discussion is more philosophical and scientific, not religious, but we will be touching religious dimensions as well. So, what is my focus now in this part of the discussion, that is gender identity and gendered representation? Now, in life coaching point of view, what matters is person, not gender. Please write these words that I am telling you so that you are involved. And some people, if they don't listen properly, they can read your comment and they can make sense of this highly academic intellectual discussion. So far I said gender identity, gendered representation. What matters is person, not gender. What matters is person, not gender. Sex is a biological reality. We differentiate sex from gender. Gender is mostly sociological, while sex is biological. So if you are male, you are female, you are transgender, you are more male, you are more female, there are five genders and there are five sexes. So biologically, it is a reality that man is man and woman is woman, because there are very clear differences in morphology, physiology, endocrinology, very clear differences. The hormones which are produced by both the bodies are different. Structure is different. Function is different. Endocrinology means hormones. For example, testosterone, oxytocin, you know, different, the bodies have different hormones. So male and female, they produce different hormones. Some of the hormones are different. Their reproductive system, their biology, pregnancy, delivery of children, some of the genitals, the sex organs, not some, but all of the sex organs are different. So this is biological difference which science do recognize. Now when we come to gender, gender identity, in developed countries like Europe, G8 countries, Japan, even China, in these countries, gender identity is the personal sense of one's own gender. So gender identity can correlate with a person's assigned sex at birth or can differ from it. Gender expression typically reflects a person's gender identity. But this is not always the case. So, gender identity, what is my gender? This is my personal sense of my own gender. In what gender do I feel satisfied? So, that is my gender. So, I invite you to study gender studies in detail, which is an interdisciplinary academic field. Why? Because you have to understand philosophy, international relations, sociology, biology. Then you can understand gender studies, multi-disciplines. And then you go for gendered representation. How you are represented by the society. One is your own gender identity, and then it is gendered representation. So we have two things. One is pro-life and the other is pro-choice. These are two very important terms to understand this discussion academically. There are two terms. One is pro-life and the other is pro-choice. We must differentiate these two terminologies. Then we can discuss this subject academically, rationally, philosophically, analytically, applying our critical thinking. Otherwise, we are emotional persons. If a famous person says something about one choice or another choice, and then those people become very famous, millions of people, they watch them, but without any substance. Like last night, the debate between Marvi and that other guy, Qamar. Now it is so famous. Everybody is talking about that. And everybody is looking at that debate from his or her point of view. But this discussion is purely academic, scholarly, scientific, philosophical. We will be discussing religious aspects also. But usually I avoid religious aspects. Why? Because religion is so diverse. And in religion, context and applicability are very, very difficult to implement. Context and its applicability today. A religious injunction, a religious command revealed 2,000 years back in Bible and 1,400 years back in the Holy Quran, and you are applying it today. So this is a huge debate. Very, very huge debate. For example, two women and one man, their evidence in the court of law, especially in financial matters, how can you justify it today? I don't have any answer to this question. This is why I avoid it. If a person in Canada or in Europe asks me, even in Pakistan, that how it is possible that a PhD woman will take another woman for evidence to the court of law and an illiterate man will go alone because he is a man. And women, though she is PhD, but she is half, she has to take another woman. Now, I don't have any answer to this thing. The only answer is context. Context. Technically, it is called Shani Nazul. That when this command was revealed 1400 years ago, the situation was different. At that time, women were not so educated. They would forget things. This is why this was a support for the woman to take another woman for evidence in the court of law. But today, when women are highly educated, she can be a doctor, an engineer, she can be an MBA, she can be PhD. So why she has to take another woman? She has her mobile, computer, internet, Google, calculator, technology. So here I am stuck. This is, you know, there is no way out. Nobody has answer to this question in the whole world. So this is why I don't discuss it. And if you say it is the situation at that time, so it means that today it is not applicable. And when today it is not applicable, so mullahs and religious people, they will attack you. How you are saying that it is not applicable today? Religion is for the whole life. It is for eternity. It is till the day of judgment. You cannot say that today it is not applicable. So this is a very, very dangerous discussion. When you discuss this thing, so you make religion limited only to 23 years. When the holy book was revealed, or for some more years. Today, 21st century, information age, computer, internet, technology, digital age. So you cannot discuss these things. How can you think that a daughter should take half of the inheritance as compared to her brother? Why? Brother also gets all the portions, not only the daughter. Why women can be beaten and men cannot be beaten? Why there can be four wives, but there can't be four husbands? So these are some of the questions that religion does not have any answer for these. The only answer is context. But when you say context, situation, Shani Nazul, so then you make religion limited to a particular time and then its applicability is questioned today. And then there are some customs. For example, the other day I was watching a video, an interview of a woman, and she said that I went through halala 3 times. 3 times I went through halala. H-A-L-A-L-A, halala. So the interviewer asked, how you went 3 times? She said that my husband is Hanafi. He is following Hanafi fiqh. And he is a man with stress, tension, not a stable personality. He is all the time in angry mood. So he is divorcing me all the times. When he is angry, he divorced me. And after the anger, when he realized that he committed a mistake, so he wants to come back. In Hanafi fiqh, this woman must sleep with another man. Then she can come back to that original husband. And then he would request his friend, please sleep with my woman with my wife for 1 day, and then I can take her back. Once happened, twice happened, thrice happened. And she slept with 3 of his friends. Sexual intercourse. Because according to halala, another man must do sexual intercourse. And then there are so many implications. She may get pregnant. She may love the other man. And then there are so many disputes. So how can you justify such religious things in today's modern era? So this is why religion has no solutions. In this regard, specifically, either you should be very bold, you have to challenge that it was only context, it is not applicable today. And when you want to make it applicable today, then you have no answers. So this is a vicious cycle. You are stuck what to do and what not to do. So I was discussing pro-life and pro-choice discussion. Pro-life means that when a woman is pregnant and she doesn't want the child. So this is called pro-choice. This is my choice whether I deliver this baby or not. And the other one is pro-life. No, that is a baby, that is a human being. You should not kill him or her. She or he must be born, whatever is your choice, whether you want to be mother or not. But now as you are pregnant, so you must deliver the baby. So this is called pro-life. You have to save the life, not your choice. So from here, this Aurat March and feminism started. That what should the women do? Where is her choice? Because biologically, she can become pregnant. And sex is a natural desire. Sex is a natural desire. And women, by her personality, is more beautiful, delicate, intelligent, sensitive. She is emotionally intelligent. Even in IQ, she is also better than men in many of the studies. So men, right from the beginning of the history of humankind, even from the time of Greeks, before Greeks, everybody that is against women. So this is why feminism started as a range of social movements, political movements, and ideologies that aim to define, establish, and achieve the political, economic, personal, and social equality of the sexes. Now, when you have social equality, personal equality, economic equality, political equality. So this struggle is called feminism. And when you talk only of opportunity, that give me equal opportunity, this is called equity. If there is a post for the manager in a bank, so you cannot advertise that the manager must be a male. You cannot write this. As I said in the beginning, what matters is person, not gender. Biology, sex is important. So if you are a man and you are heterosexual by choice or by design, by biology, by nature, and you like the opposite sex, so for you to be a woman, the other person is important. If you are man, you must need a woman as a partner. Because by nature, by biology, by your genes, you are heterosexual. If a person is homosexual, then that person will be searching for biologically. This is naturally, scientifically, that person will be searching for another person of the same sex. This is in his or her biology. So when sex becomes important, when there is intimacy, when you want to become one, when you want to become partners, when you want to marry, when you want to have the mother of your children, so you must have a woman gender, a woman sex. You want to do sexual act, sexual intercourse, so for that, you have your own biology. If you like women, so you will be searching women. And if you like some other thing, so that is up to you. That is your own biology. So what I mean, my approach is that what matters, that is your sex or gender, your being male or female, when there is intimacy, intimate relationship. You want to touch each other bodies. You want to kiss each other. Now, in the Western society, your lips, your sexual organs, your breast, these are your for your partner. Rest of the body doesn't matter. So these parts, whether you have the lips of a woman or a man, whether you have the sexual parts of a male or female, these matter when there is sexual desire. Otherwise, for me, you are just a person. So why in Aurat March, the people have different slogans? I am a teacher. I am a male. I am speaking here. So my gender, my sex does not matter. What matters? My words, my communication skills, my arguments, how I am logical, how I am applying my critical thinking. Why you should be interested that whether I should be a male or female? My identity as a male or female is important only when there is intimacy. When you are in romantic love. Romantic love. Not platonic love or other kinds of love. So why Aurat March starts? That you people respect the other gender. Whatever dress she is wearing, whatever behavior she is having, you are nobody to measure her dressing style, dressing size, what she wears, what makeup she wears, what she is doing, what she is not doing. So this is coincided with International Women's Day on 8 March. Now this day, International Women's Day, is celebrated on the 8th of March every year. Because it is a focal point in the movement for women's rights. Women were always kept under pressure. They were not allowed to participate socially, economically, politically, And this, why we say, why male? Why not male? Why only female? Because women, they have genuine problems. They have, their rights are really important. She cannot go for swimming. For example, in a country like Pakistan, do you have swimming pools for women where she can go and swim the way she wants? If she goes to a beach side, so she will be just walking and she cannot go and swim and enjoy the waves of the ocean. And she has been denied basic human rights, fundamental human rights like education. Education is a basic fundamental human right. So they have a lot of issues. This is why women's rights, that is more of the part of the discussion on Aurat March. Now, Pakistan Amnesty International or Amnesty International throughout the world, they are supporting Aurat March. Why? Because men, they are in huge danger that when these women will come out, who will cook for us? Because they want ready-made food. Now, it is very difficult to cook food, to go to kitchen in hot weather or cold weather, to prepare the food, then bring the food to the table, then eat it. So that is quite, you know, difficult task. They are used, they are lazy, and they want that the women, it should be their servants. They should take care of the kitchen and they should take care of the bedroom. And now the women, they are coming out of the bedroom and they are coming out of the kitchens. Because cooking has nothing to do with the being male or female. So when they say, Mera jism, meri ghairat, ye teri jagir nahi, rasm o rivaj ko todne mein koi taakhir nahi. Mera jism, meri ghairat, ye teri jagir nahi. Rasm o rivaj ko todne mein ab koi taakhir nahi. Why these conventions, these customs, these so-called honor, all these things are only to keep the women as your servant and as a person who is preparing food for you and ironing clothes for you. And why not in the West, I see many Pakistanis and they don't join the Western lifestyle. And I ask them why. They say it is so difficult. You have to find a girl. You have to talk to a girl. You have to invite her to a restaurant. You have to dance with that girl. You have to go to mountains with that girl. You have to climb mountains. You have to play a lot of sports. You have to do a lot of stuff. On the other hand, my parents bring a ready-made girl for me and she comes to my bedroom and I do with her whatever I want. So this is far more easier than involving a girl in romantic relationship that she really loves you, loves your body, loves your sex style, loves your cooking, loves the way you are, and it takes time. It is not easy that you conquer a girl, because girl, because of her biology, she has more patience. Her hormones and her sensitivity and her sensibility is far more advanced as compared to men. So this is why men have intelligence, society, customs, honor. I am sincere with you. You remain at home. Don't come out. Because when you... So you are my honor. We will be dishonored. And a lot of excuses to imprison women in the four walls of the house. So they want fundamental human rights. Now, fundamental means fun. Fundamental. They also want to have fun in their lives. So before I proceed, I would like to take now your questions, because sometimes I speak more and I forget that you also have some questions in your mind. So please go ahead openly, frankly, whatever comes in your mind, ask. And I will, being a gender studies expert, I have worked with UNDP, I have worked with the United Nations in different projects on gender equality. I am a teacher of gender studies and I have full command on gender studies. So you can ask me any question from any angle so that we have threadbare discussion on the 10 points given above or any question that you have. Don't go for authority, because to go for authority, that is quite easy. That person said this thing, so this will be easy. It is like having a ready-made food that is really quite easy. But if you go to kitchen, cook your own food and then eat it, so that is quite delicious. Some people, they enjoy cooking. So enjoying cooking is critical thinking. And just believing in somebody else, that is authority. Now, that is a very intellectual person, very famous person. He said this thing, so it means that it will be correct. No. Apply your own critical thinking, your own sense of judgment. Why the Aurat March is a revolutionary feat for Pakistan? Why it is revolutionary? Revolutionary in the sense that if you allow society, not a single woman will come out of her home. Even in the past, even today in many villages, many women, they deliver their babies inside the home. Because to take a pregnant woman at the delivery time to hospital is against the honor of their family. So this is a big revolution. Meri jism, meri marzi. My body, my choice. Because naturally, this is my body. So I am, you know, if nature, God, or anybody has created that body, but now I am the owner. Nobody, I'm not the slave of anybody that person will tell me how to utilize my body. When you as a male, you are responsible and you are master and owner of your body and somebody else cannot touch you, why you are measuring the style and the size of the dresses of other person, or you are looking at her front or back or her hairstyle or eyes or nose or face? She is not your girlfriend. She is not your wife. She has not allowed you to utilize or to use her body if she wants. So this is a revolution. The thing that for the last, I think, 3 years that the Aurat March is happening in Pakistan. This is awareness. And we are getting maturity. There will be time that it will be more sophisticated. Now, there may be some slogans which some people may not like. But this is the first step towards a great destination of gender equality and gender equity. We must fully support them in whatever form. Because what is good and what is bad? When it doesn't harm you and when it doesn't harm others. So that is good thing. So if a woman comes out, goes on a street, on a road and have some slogans, some banners, and she is not touching you, why you are in danger? Why you feel danger? So this is something which is really revolutionary. Sir, what is your opinion is behind the views expressed by Khalilur Rahman Qamar? Khalilur Rahman Qamar is, I didn't watch the drama, but he is a female hater. He does not like women as a whole. These are people, they hate women. This is a psychological complex. Why they hate women? Because they can't compete with women. Women are beautiful. She is elegant. Women is, you know, so attractive, so captivative. So men, because of their inferiority complex, you might have seen that, you know, men, they cannot talk to women. They tremble. They shiver. So this is in their personality, in their complex. Now myself, I don't care. I have talked to Hillary Clinton alone for 3-4 minutes. When I was deputy chief of protocol, I received her. She is Hillary Clinton, the foreign secretary of United States of America. I didn't care because I took her as person, not as woman. So I talked to her and I asked her very, very complicated questions. So what it means? Any woman comes to me, I talk to her. Welcome. What are you doing? How are you doing? This, that. And I had so many friends. I have friends. They are women. And I talk to them. There is no issue in this. But a person like this Kamar Zaman, he might, I don't know, because I have not done his psychoanalysis. I should not exaggerate things. But he seems to be having some real problem with women. And when a person is angry, so in the anger, the reality comes out. Because when you are angry, so your conscious self stops and your unconscious starts. So when you want to see a person in his or her real personality, so that is when that person is angry. So he was made angry by Marvi, and then he said those dirty words for women. So naturally, because the drama that he wrote, he made women, he was like a sympathizer of women. Sometimes you feel somebody is doing a lot of sympathy with you. Why this sympathy? Because this sympathy, this person is going to destroy you. First, that person will take you into confidence and then will do whatever that person wants. So I think that he has got some real problems with the women. I heard some of his story, his childhood story, that he was a very poor person and then he did not have money and then he started writing. And I should not say this thing publicly, but his wife, I didn't find her an attractive woman. So maybe he has got some bad problems with her own family. Although these things should not be told here. It is just, psychoanalysis. I am doing my psychoanalysis from distance. Maybe I am wrong. So women makes our life easy. They cook, wash the clothes, care of her children after all this. They prepare for herself or her husband to give husband. So this is the main problem. Why women should cook? Why she should wash clothes? Why? Men can't do it. Washing clothes or cooking food, the best chefs in the world in hotels, in 5-star hotels, they are men. They are not women. Why we have made her limited to cooking and washing? Because we are afraid. If there is a beautiful shopkeeper, a woman is shopkeeper. So do you think that the men, the people, the customer will go to that man with big belly and abdomen and big beard and ugly face, having smell from his nose? Nobody will go there. People would love to be attended by an elegant lady. So this is a great conspiracy against women, that your job is inside home and you just take care of kitchen and take care of your washing area and your bedroom, and that's all. Don't come to shops. Don't drive trucks. Nowadays, it is the technology era. Driving a truck is not a problem because it's just push button technology. You just push the button and you can drive a truck. Why a man should drive a truck? Why not women? Is there any logic behind it? No. Our own phobias, our own fears of women, because they are more advanced than men.
Sir, if you look on other side, Aurat March may promote vulgarity. The last time women with banners in hand showed vulgar pictures.
Now, what is vulgarity and what is not vulgarity? This is again a question. And this is not absolute. This is relative. Now, a woman in England, in Germany, wearing shorts, mini frock, and she is not vulgar. But in Peshawar, not Peshawar so much, but in some Pashtun village, a woman, only her heels, if the heels are visible, so that is vulgarity. Actually, the body of the women or men, when it is in bed and you are doing sexual act with mutual consent, that is the only time that you are interested in the body. Why you are interested in her body when she is just walking on a street? She is not your wife. She is not, you are not her husband. That is her choice. What kind of clothes she want to wear? Why you are in danger? You think that in the West, everybody is doing sexual act with every woman? No. Their girlfriends are more jealous than our so-called wives. Because when they don't love, they don't do sex. For them, sex and love both are synonyms. Making love. Making love means doing sex. A girl, an educated girl in the West, will never go for sex if she does not love that boy or that man. And love means after 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, company, discussions, dinners, dances, going for tourism, and after that they fall in love and then they go for sexual act in the bed. So this vulgarity is in our minds. This vulgarity is not in her body or in her dress.
So do you think the constitutional rights that women has are not sufficient?
You know, people say that it is written in the Holy Quran, or it is a tradition of the Holy Prophet, or flan scholar said this thing, or it is written in the Constitution. This is not the case. Something written in the Constitution, something written in a holy book, is not guarantee that that thing will happen. The actual thing is the social acceptance. These women, when they come on 8th of the March, in Aurat March, and they sensitize people. You know why there are so many earthquakes now? Why the world is trembling? Why the people are shaking? Why everybody, including myself, is talking about the Aurat March? I am a human rights activist. This is why I am talking. I take this opportunity that today, for the last 1 hour, around 1 hour, I am speaking on this topic. And new people are listening and participating. Everybody on social media, on Facebook, is either supporting Aurat March or against the Aurat March. Huge discussion going on. Everybody is in trouble. Everybody is trembling, shaking. What happened? Women came out. If women, you consider that she is so weak, then why you are in trouble? Let her do whatever they want. But they know that this will crumble the whole societal structure. And this is why, along with constitution, such civil society movements are important. Because constitution, that is a legal document. Now, to implement that constitution, you have to prepare the society. For example, child marriage. If you go for religion, in the religion there is no limit for child marriage. Even a 9 years girl can be married religiously. Now you have to make laws. And when you make law that you cannot make a girl married till she is adult, 18 years old, now you made the law. But how to prepare the society? Society you have to prepare by social awareness. And when you come to street, when you celebrate days like in Women International Day, so that is one step forward that you are preparing minds of the people and they will be now ready for the constitution. Just writing something in the constitution, that is not enough. For example, who is Muslim, who is not Muslim? Who believes in the finality of the prophethood and who does not believe in the finality of the prophethood? It is already written in the Holy Quran. It is already written in the constitution. Why then your mullahs block the whole country for that law? Why everybody is coming out? It is there in the education as a fundamental right is already written in the constitution. But there is no hue and cry when we talk about the educational rights of people. Why only we are targeting women? Because this is our own inferiority complex. I, as a brave, bold man, I don't care. Because I know that I can conquer a woman with my words, with my personality, with my money, with my understanding, with my physique, with my color, with my physical, mental, spiritual, and emotional capabilities. Any woman will be happy with me. So I have no this complex talking about the women's rights. Those people who are chichadi, pipri type of people who cannot talk, I cannot talk because of this and that. These kind of people, they will be against women because they cannot talk to women. They cannot face women. To face a woman, it is not easy. Try. So those people who are opposing Aurat March are women's rights. Go into their backgrounds. They are weak people. They are uneducated. They don't know what is philosophy. They don't know what is knowledge. They will be a very, very weak person. A strong person will never oppose Aurat March. Now, again, the same question of religion. Naqisul aqal. Ki aurat bhai pasli se paida hui hai aur naqisul aqal hai. For me, religion solution is in these two words. Context or applicability. These injunctions by the Holy Prophet or anybody, it has a context. Maybe a stupid woman did something bad and maybe this was spoken that this woman is not intelligent. And another person, Abu Harir or somebody, heard it and he made it a tradition that all the women are stupid. So this is logically, it is not possible. How all women can be stupid? Naqisul aqal means stupid, unintelligent. There are women, they have led the world. They are leaders. Highly educated women, PhD holders, CSPs, officers. They are running a lot of departments, prime ministers, presidents. So the problem is that you cannot generalize a commandment that all the women, they are stupid and all the men, they are intelligent. No. What matters is person, not gender. There may be stupid men, there may be stupid women. There may be intelligent women, there may be intelligent men. What matters is person, personality. And personality is the product of your biology and your environment.
While studying the issues and movements of women in Pakistan, which academic tools would be adopted to analyze it critically or adopt the gender studies approaches applicable to Western society? Very good question, technical question. I love such kind of discussions. These usual stuff I don't like. My personality is very deep and I love scholarly academic things. Now, East and West. These are only geographical terminologies. There is no East and there is no West.
Remember, there is no east and there is no west. Why? Because the world is a globe. It is round. So how can you say east and west? These are just some terminologies that we understand the world, that this is east and this is west. In the east, in the so-called east, we have Japan, we have China, we have, you know, some developed countries as well. China is not that developed, but Japan is developed. Japan is part of G7. Now, what happened in the West, the so-called West that we call? They were worse than the East. When India, Japan, the other day I delivered a lecture in Philosophy for Life Moment. In that lecture, I discussed Japanese philosophy, Chinese philosophy, and some old Greek philosophy. So Japan, India, and China, they were more advanced than the West, today's West. So when we talk about the developed countries and underdeveloped countries, so today, Islamabad is like Paris. And Tandwalai or Khan or Shadirai or some small village, Mulhal or some Chakwal or some, I don't know, I remember the names. You know, those are better than Africa. Within Islamabad, you go to Appara and you go to E7, you go to F7, you go to Jinnah Super and you go to some other place. A huge difference. So from the West, if we love their technology, their science, their philosophy, their advancement, their economy, we must also understand their culture. We must also understand their culture. Why they have this culture? It is because of their development. Why a woman should spend, you know, huge amount of money on buying those expensive dresses for the marriages? Culture, development go together. If you love their technology, you have to love their culture as well. You cannot separate these two. Why we are backward? Why we are underdeveloped? Because 50% of our human resources in the form of women, we have imprisoned them in the four walls. Bring the women out. You have in Pakistan 220 million people. So 110 million human resources, almost, they are redundant. They are doing nothing. They are just cooking and they are just washing utensils. Bring them out. Make them doctors, engineers. Make them philosophers. Make them technologists. Make them shopkeepers. Make them truck drivers. And you see how our economy develops. And when you see a woman driving a truck and you say, no, this is against my culture. So if it is against your culture, then remain underdeveloped.
There exists a concept of equality in both male and female in millennial of Pakistan as well, but therefore exists generation gap between them and their parents.
Yes, generation gap. It is a reality. Today, young people, those who are following me, those who are discussing with me things, they will be far better than their forefathers. So let us revolutionize Pakistan. Let us modernize Pakistan. And today I have given you the point that culture and economy, culture and knowledge, they go together. You are backward, this is why you have this culture. If you were modern, you would have not got that culture.
Is Aurat March a Western agenda?
Yes. It may be a Western agenda because these burqa women, when they go to France, they go to Canada, and face is index. Face is index. Face is your identity. And they don't show their faces. And they think that they are criminals or what they are. We can't see their face. So they don't, you know, in this global village, maybe they in Amnesty International, United Nations, they are supporting these movements, that why these backward people, wild people, they are still hiding their women like dead bodies in the coffin. Why the women, they don't come out and they have their confident style, they are walking. You know, I have seen in the West, half naked women, but you cannot look at them if they don't want. They are half naked, but they are so confident and they are so strong that you cannot look at them. So as the West, IMF is giving us money to run our institutions, World Bank is sponsoring our projects. Maybe, I don't have any evidence, but maybe it is their agenda, and it is a good agenda, because they want some educated people, some modern people, some elegant people, some dignified people. Why you are hiding a woman in the burqa? Is she a criminal?
Should sex without marriage be allowed in Pakistan? Marriages have already become a very good question. This is one of my favorite questions. You know, we are hypocritical. Hypocritical means that we are paradoxical. We are telling lies. We are neither ready for the marriage at 9 years or 12 years or 17 years or 15 years. And we are also not ready for boyfriend-girlfriend relationship. This is a total disaster. You have to accept one of these two. Like the other days, a couple, 18 years old, they married. And they were so popular for a few days in the social media. What happens? This girl in 18 years, she may be somewhere in 14th class or 15th class of her education. She gets pregnant. Now, family planning is also not allowed, according to some religious scholars. She gets pregnant. Now, how she will continue her education? Do you think that a married couple in 18 years, they can continue education? University education is usually comes to an end in 24 years of age. So you have to decide. Either early marriages, because you are adult in 15 years, 16, 18, 19 years, you are biologically adult. Your hormones started functioning. Your estrogen and your testosterone are now functioning. As you have hunger, you have thirst. Similar is your sex desire. You have to find a way for it. Otherwise, then you become psychologically patient. Then you are frustrated. Then you are going for psychological problems. So you have to find a way. Now, marriages are so complicated, so expensive. First, your education, 25 years. Then your job, 30 years. Then making a new house, 35 years. So most of the people, they are now getting married after 30 years, 30, 35 years of age. Your bloom, your age, your energy is dwindling. You don't enjoy your carnal desires. So you have to find a way. Either boyfriend-girlfriend relationship, you have to make it a culture, or you have to go for early marriages. There is no other way. If there is any other way, so you suggest it. I am talking naturally, philosophically, humanly. I am not talking religiously. Now, some of the Muslims, they have found out muta, siga, is the solution. And now in Saudi Arabia, they have also implemented temporary marriage. Now, what is marriage? Mia biwi razi, to kya karega qazi? When two adult persons agree for sexual act, this is called marriage.
why we have made it such a complicated phenomena? Why we involve that the marriage is not between two persons, marriage is between two families? Whether the marriage is for you and for your wife, or this is for your father and mother and uncles and cousins and brothers and sisters. Total nonsense.
Sir, once you said I am against separate education for male and female. But sir, I have seen so many cases of illegal affairs, harassment and other.
When a girl is really educated, she speaks fluent English, she or her sandals are her beautiful shoes, elegant dress, when she walks with her black glasses and open hair in any university, no dirty male can look at her. But when she is a miserable kind of meek, humble, and looking here and there, so then she becomes the victim, the target of every dirty male. So how to stop sexual harassment? Make your women highly confident, educated women. And before talking to her or before harassing her, these men will think 100 times. Make her educated, confident, doctor, engineer, officer, first position holder, walking with style, with dignity, with honor. Then so-called these young people, they will be then trembling, shivering around her. Because she is elegant. She is beauty. She is elegant. She is such a great personality. Only we target weak women, never strong women. Now, poverty and economic issues, we do not like poor people. Wealth is important. You must be a rich person. In my formula of happiness, we promise 1W stands for wealth. Wealth is very important. And girls, they are so intelligent. They understand that I cannot pass my life with a poor guy just he is talking to me, my sweetheart, my beloved, I love you and I will bring stars for you. She says that before bringing stars, bring some water, bring some beer, bring some bread, bring some butter, buy some clothes for me. Forget about your stars. This is why girls, being highly intelligent, they identify that who is that man who can serve, who can work, and who doesn't work.
Can Aurat March be a hope for to unite people for cause of gender?
Yes, exactly. This is awareness. Everybody, including you and me, today we are talking about Aurat March. Why? Gender equality, gender equity. Great, huge opportunity. If we don't like their style, let us do it in our style, in more elegant, more educated style.
Do you think women in Pakistan will not abuse the power they get through Aurat March? Some feminists hate men for no reason. Will that engender men march in future?
So when I was in CSA, Civil Services Academy Lahore, we made men rights committee. Because the whole attention would go to the female officers, administrators. They would be all the time welcoming women and giving seats to women, talking to the girls, what I can do for you. So you are right. But this will increase competition. Both genders, they will compete to get power, to be attractive, to be smart. You see, in the West, every man goes to gym. Every man wants to be smart, otherwise he is rejected by the girl. In our society, just to be a male, that is sufficient. You may have a big abdomen, a big belly. You may be just, a totally ugly person. Totally, you are not taking bath for 10 days. It doesn't matter. But as you are male, you are acceptable. And she has to do makeup and she has to beautify her and adorn her and good dresses and doing a lot of things to please you. Why? Gender equality is that both should be attractive. Both should be strong. Both should be happy. So a time will come that then we will be struggling for men rights, and that will be a healthy competition. Why not?
I don't know, Ruhan, where Quran has written these things. If you can give some reference, so we will be thankful. Why there is a need of Aurat March when a major proportion of women are getting all facilities at home, nothing is ideal. So my dear Kamran Ahmad, having facilities at home, you also have facilities in jail. Jail, you have bed, you have food, you have washroom, everything you have. Why not go to jail? And free food, free bed, everything is free in jail. This is not just home. Women want to swim, they want to run, they want to play football, they want to play, I don't like cricket, but still, let me say cricket. And they want to climb mountains. They want to run speed cars. They want to go to beaches. This is not just home, eating, drinking, sleeping, and that's all.
Can culture of a conservative society be changed? If so, how?
It is being changed. Salim Khan, ask your father, your mother, how was the situation at your village and how it is today? Things are changed. Today we are talking about Aurat March. And Aurat, they are coming in spite of all the problems, in spite of all the obstacles, in spite of all the opposition. But they are coming to the streets. On 8th of March, you will see women. So this is a big change. Things are changing. Be ready for the change.
Sir, in burqa issue, will we follow Islam or Western agenda? Because Islam firmly emphasizes on parda.
So again, it is up to interpretation. When Hazrat Aisha, she was commanding in the battle against Hazrat Ali, and she was commander-in-chief of the army. So do you think that she would be in burqa? In burqa, you cannot move. Burqa is your freedom of movement. You cannot move in burqa. You cannot run. If there is a fire, you cannot run in burqa. You cannot shoot in burqa. You cannot climb, a horse in burqa. Burqa is just a mechanism to control women, because men are afraid of women. So this is up to interpretation. This is why I don't discuss things from religious point of view. Now, Imam Abu Hanifa, he says that face is not part of the parda. Illa ma zahara minha. The interpretation is that whatever is revealed. Now, whatever is revealed, maybe your face, maybe your legs, maybe your hair, maybe your body. It depends. So religion is so controversial, and religion so many sects. Now in Iran, in Shia Iran, women, they are pilots, they are engineers, they are doctors, they are doing everything. But in another part of Muslim world, women, they cannot show their faces. So who is correct and who is not correct? Huge debate, and we could not resolve it in 1400 years. So I don't want to start it again. There is no solution. For me, philosophy, spirituality, science, that is enough. So all the best, guys. Fully participate in Aurat March, at least mentally, at least in social media. the warriors of social media, at least support them. If you don't have the courage to go to a road and street, or you don't have time and energy, don't do it. But at least support them morally, give them ethical, moral support, because when a woman comes out of her home, she is a brave, brave, brave lady. Let us salute to her.